Welcome to the second part of the tutorial, where we learn how to use hand-painted masks and combine their influence with procedural logic. To create a new mask, we enter the Paint Mask tool and click on the Create button. We create a mask called Trees, which will decide where the trees grow. Let's paint this mask somewhere. Then we enter the tree species, growth mask, and add a Biomes mask sample node. We'll add the influence of this parameter to the rest of the material so that the mask works additively to all the procedural logic. We regenerate the world, and we can see the trees spawned in the region covered by the mask. Another thing we can do with a mask is to remove all the foliage in a given area. The easiest way to achieve this is by creating an empty subbiome, one with no species inside. Subbiomes have materials controlling their placement, similarly to species. We edit that material in the empty subbiome and add a Biomes mask sample node to make the subbiome spawn where the remove foliage mask is painted. We'll multiply the mask value by some constant to make sure this subbiome wins against other subbiomes which may accidentally output values larger than 1. Then we paint the remove foliage mask, and the trees disappear. Masks can be used in arbitrary ways. For example, we could create a mask that only removes large foliage, like trees, and then make certain species not grow where that mask is painted. Let's paint over that mask. We can see that the trees disappeared, but the grass is still there. That's it for this tutorial. If you liked it, please subscribe to our channel and visit our website, errantphoton.com.